Well, production designer is coming up with the style of the movie, the visuals, trying to tell the story in the best possible way.
Good team. Whoa! Oh. Whoa.
The aesthetic is something that a few years ago would have been considered impossible. For a long time, we had been doing traditional animation. It was always the same style, and I always felt like it should keep evolving. Complex lighting was very clearly a step forward.
You'll love this, I promise.
In most of the traditionally animated movies, the character is a flat sticker.
Our main objective was to try to make the characters blend as much as possible.
The problem was that there was no tool to achieve that. I tried to find existing software and kind of hack the program. I prepared the test. When Sergio first saw it, he was just blown away.
I can't believe that this looks this gorgeous. For the first time, you have a traditionally made film where the character in the background looked at exactly from the same world.
Ow! Go home, you loser!
Oh, yeah? Well, you're too far, you're gone.
Jesper, by his actions and his transformation, influences the environment and the people in the town, and the town itself changes.
Now, would you take a look at that?
At the beginning, we use a lot of pointy shapes, gray colors and moods to show that this is an environment where everything is kind of out of balance. So at the end, it kind of turns into this pretty beautiful village that feels very grounded and just full of colors and pleasant atmosphere.
I wasn't smiling. I was squinting from the sun.
Right.
Every frame of the animation is crafted by the artist, but production designers develop our methods to be able to create this unique look.